Hi everyone, my name is Ming Ming. Now I will present the Hongnan Finance Limited to yours. So here is the title of the presentation. For the company profile, Hongnan Finance was incorporated in 1961 as a small and medium enterprise and has evolved to become Singapore's largest finance company with a distribution network of 28 branches. The principal activity of the company are to accept deposits from the public and to use this deposit together with its own capital resource in the provision of finance, which including hire purchase, leasing, factory, mortgages, and the secured loans. For product and service, it offers various deposit products comprising fixed deposit, savings account, business current account, and the corporate time deposit and personal loans. The company also provides SME loans consisting of commercial and industrial property loans and so on. In addition, it offers a range of corporate finance services comprising equity fund leasing. Last one is our achievement of the Hongnan Finance. In 2013, Hongnan Finance has been ranked as Singapore's most influential corporations and SMEs. In 2014, Hongnan Finance has awarded ASEAN Finance Company of the Year. Next one is about the quantitative analysis. Those are the competitors of Hongnan Finance. Comparing company with other companies in the industry is also a good way to do analysis. I have analyzed the total asset for Hongnan Finance in 5 years. We can see from the table, from 2009 to 2013, the total asset of Hongnan Finance are stable, which are bought to increase the value of a firm and benefit the firm's operations. Next is about the cash flow balance. As we know, cash flow is a key indicator of financial health. A positive and increased cash flow signal means a good financial health of the company. From the table, we can see that from 2010 to 2013, the cash flow balance for the Hongnan Finance has a bit fluctuate. However, it's still considered as increasing. Therefore, we found that Hongnan Finance has a stable and have a better buying power. Next one is about the net profit margin. I use the formula here, net profit divided by revenue. So you can see from the table, at least 3 years data of the Hongnan Finance. Just take a look at 2013 one. As we know, the higher profit margin, the more net sales dollar are providing profit to the business, and the fewer net sales dollar are absorbed by expense. A percentage of 42.21 means that every $1 net sales generates 0.42 of net operating profit. The decrease in net profit margin in 2013 is partly due to a long shadow cast on the world market by the US fiscal cliff and the Eurozone debt crisis. The company profit margin of 42.21 indicates that the company has a well-planned competitive strategies and also have a good control over its expenditures. Next is about the earnings per share and the PE ratios. From the table, I use Hongliang Finance compared with its competitors, Maybank and the AMLB Holdings. We can see that Hongliang Finance has 15.9 EPS and Maybank has 0.76. AMLB Holding has 0.6. For the PE ratios, Hongliang Finance has a lower PE ratio, which is 10.88, and the Maybank is 13.21. AMLB Holding is 11.97. By that, we know that earnings per shares measure the net profit attributable to one share. For ordinary shares, investors can earn 0.159 cents. As compared to its competitor, Hongliang Finance has a good performance as their competitor has a lower EPS. For the PE ratio, a higher PE ratio indicates that the stock is priced relatively high to its earning, and the company with higher PE ratio therefore seem more expensive. Investors are willing to buy Hongliang Finance Limited shares as compared to its competitors. Investors have more confidence that the Hongliang Finance Limited will do well in the futures. Next is about the return on equity and the return on asset. Return on equity shows the relationship between net profit and the shareholders' investment in the economy. The ROE of the company has fluctuated over the years, but all indicators are positive. That means they still gain profit in the invest. For the ROA, measures a company's success in using its asset to earn profit. The company has decreased in ROA from 1.4% to 0.6% within 4 years. This shows that the company utilize asset not very well. Next is about the qualitative analysis. First chapter is the strength of the companies. For diversity, Hongliang Finance Limited controls 14 list companies, which involve in the financial service, manufacturing, distribution, property, and the infrastructure development. For identity, Hongliang Finance Limited is one of the largest conglomerates in the ASEAN regions. It has diversified workforce and have more than 40,000 staff worldwide. The company also have healthy financial profile and a strong presence in Malaysia. For the second sector, which is the weakness of the companies, Hongliang Finance face a geographic reach problem because it is limited to the Southeast Asia only. The operations are concentrated mostly in Malaysia, and it is very dependent on financial market, which is volatile in nature. Next is the opportunity of the companies. Hongliang Finance has an optimistic economic forecast in 2014, and it also has the diversified offering to increase customer base. The company has increased the expansions through mergers and acquisitions. Last one is about the chart of the companies. The Hongliang Finance Limited faces a strong competition in the market. It is very easy to be affected by any change in regulation and the rules. This is very dangerous for a company to grow in the market. Moving on to the technical analysis, we can look at the Bollinger, MACD, and the RSI. This is the example of Bollinger for Hongliang Finance Limited. We can look at this chain here. From 2009 to 2012, the indicators is keep going up. However, it dropped a lot during 2013. However, it has recovered in 2014. Similar with BOLL, MACD and RSI are used for analyzing the performance of the companies. The Bloomberg chart also shows the trend of Hongliang Finance Limited. So now I will talking about the future forecast for Hongliang Finance Limited. From this chart, we see that it predicts that the revenue will increase in 2014 and 2015. I also find out the consensus recommendation from professional which advise to hold Hongliang Finance stock. But don't be confused about the unperformance one, because this one is done by the previous consensus forecast. The whole stock is for the latest one. This is the improvement of Hongliang Finance Limited. As we know, the company didn't do well in 2013 since it occurred a bad market that has caused a huge loss for the companies. So in order to gain more profit in 2014 or 2015, the company has do some improvement. Going forward, Hongliang Finance Limited aim to maintain moderate growth in loan and the customer deposit portfolios to manage the squeeze in margins. They will innovate and create relevant customer programs and offers. Further, they will optimize the use of extensive branch network and strengthen the key business partners to better serve customers. For conclusion, since economic forecast for 2014 is a cautiously optimistic one, global economies are expected to recover further. Company also make some improvement to increase finance. Therefore, I think investor can invest in Hongliang Finance since it has a expected performance in future years, and the professional also approve that this is a good way to invest to the companies. So now I will end my presentation, and thank you for paying attention.